Tired of placing this table, something too big, and placed in front of him. reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them. Like the other people who have no hope, we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds, together with them, to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you shall comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
cannot be here with you on this very sad day from around Ireland, from England and from Australia, America and Canada and other parts of the world. I'm grateful for some of your friends who made an effort to be here with you today. We gather on this miserable Monday with dark clouds. These dark clouds have been on top of us for the last week, last Wednesday. The dark clouds here today match the darkness that I'm sure you were feeling as we gather around Stephen Doherty's remains. As we have gathered these past 3 days to offer comfort and consolation to Stephen's heartbroken family and friends, to Aidan and Caroline, to Chloe and Grace, mindful of Daniel, mindful of Jamie Mitchell, and many of you, his aunts, uncles, cousins, very close friend Alana, many relatives in a wide, very wide circle of friends that have been out in the rain week after day, the last couple of days, and were outside the church today. Stephen's tragic death has cast a very dark cloud over all of us inside and out through the church, along with New Haven. From the moment when Stephen's remains was found, Stephen's true feelings and thoughts over the past long time have been revealed. It's a painful revelation for you, his family and friends, despite the fact that Stephen himself, the very close friends, the great support of extended family, with very close workmates, very close teammates in League and Sarsfields. Despite how he himself and set up a little supportive group for his friends when they were in a dark place and brought them out of that place, and even continued to support them with uplifting words and actions. Yet he was unable to call to his friends for help, to help him out of darkness in his dark place. Stephen's family and all of you were completely exposed in the dark as to where Stephen was in himself and how he felt, as you would have done for him what he was able to do for you. The Stephen family home, there is a very much enlarged photograph over the stove in the sitting room of the road outside their home, with a canopy of trees leading down to this village of Leighlin and just fading off to the right. There's a powerful image that draws, I suppose, the family onto that path. And it speaks to you and it speaks to me and all of you looking at it at different levels. Stephen revealed that his time to go had come. He was finally at peace with what he wanted to do. There was nobody who could have prevented what he wanted to do for a long time. He said he would be with them, with you always and forever. He would be in your hearts forever. And he wished all of you peace, and knowing that he was happy now, his torn soul. Stephen is with you, but out of sight, so to speak. He's on that road of your heart, and just around the corner of that road, out of sight, but forever in your hearts. And that photo of the turning road outside the door speaks to us of the image in the Gospel of the two disciples on the road to Emmaus. So they met Jesus, but something prevented them from recognizing him. Their hearts burned within them as they told the story of what happened in their lives. Much like all of you,
save her in this time of grief and despair. Save her for a long time. Among them is one of Stephen Feeden. It's a sherry colour when we were in Catalina. A slice of bread. That slice of bread reminds us of the many times that all of you sat down at the kitchen table in your home and shared many meals that helped Stephen grow and become the fine young man that you let go of today. Family meals are important to you. You have many great memories of even basic meals. The church, going back over the last 27 years, the first feeding to the last. It's significant that Stephen had his lunch packed for work on the last Friday morning. The slice of bread is also a reminder of family meals, but also a powerful connection with this family here gathered in this church. We celebrate the meal of the Eucharist. Celebrate that bond of unity that joins us as the body of Christ, joins us to those who are outside the church, those with your thoughts and prayers wherever they are, and all who are throughout the world who want to be here and join us, I suppose, in the celebration of this Mass. And all of us have been nurtured round tables in our homes. So we're also nurtured here in this church and other churches, in other places we gather to celebrate Mass. And over the past 2 weeks, Sunday Masses, we've been celebrating, I suppose, the gift of the Eucharist. Yesterday was no different. Called to reflect on the Eucharist as the bread of life. The bread of life that sustains us spiritually. The same way that we physically sustained on our family tables and homes. We are nurtured by the bread of life when we gather in church for Mass. Today we are sharing the body of Christ. Giving thanks for, I suppose, the gift of the Eucharist that sustains us when we need it, especially on days like today. And yesterday the theme of reflection on the Eucharist was how the Eucharist nourished us for the journey of life. The first reading from yesterday was of the prophet Elijah. He was a great prophet. He was trying to cross a huge desert. His God had given him a task to fulfill. He wasn't long into the desert when he lay down on the first bush and he wished he was dead. But God sent an angel to feed him. Elijah reluctantly accepted the food offered to him twice. Then he took it. Instead of that food, he went for 40 days and 40 nights across the desert to reach that destination, the mountain of God. So it symbolizes how we too can be in a dark place like Elijah. Might even wish a time if we were dead. There are people around us who help us, if only we allow them to. With that support, we too can reach our destination. Stephen's family and friends are mindful of the support and courage Stephen gave to others when they were in that bad place, that hard place. And maybe the only regret is that Stephen did not allow them and his friends to bring him out of his own dark place. Human worlds always fail us. The day is no different. So we turn to that word of God that we've heard today and have been chosen today. First reading reminds us of the souls of the virtuous in the hands of God. Going around like a disaster, they're leaving us like an annihilation, but they are in peace. I forget the name of the psalm, actually. It was, I will be with you, isn't it? I will be with you. It reminds us of the Lord as we are with each other on this day. I'm not good at singing fashion, you know. So this is number one, and that is number two. So our second reading reminds us that just as Jesus died and rose again from the dead, so it would be for Stephen and all that we remember today, that they would be with the Lord forever. And with such thoughts as these, we should, I suppose, comfort one another. If we are in the presence of God this moment of sorrow, in the presence of God throughout our life, and we are in the presence of God in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Road to Mass, discussing of the events of the last enjoys my favor. Listen to him. The disciples fell on their faces, overcome with fear, but Jesus came up and touched them. Stand up, he said. Do not be afraid. Today's we gather here in church in Stephen's life. His life in the midst of you, his family, and one of you, his friends, inside and outside the church, and away from home. We give thanks for the goodness and thoughtfulness that Stephen showed and gave throughout his young life. Especially the many myriads of ways that you are giving thanks for today, especially you, his family and friends. Even as you grieve for Stephen, there are an abundance of moments and occasions that you can give thanks for and celebrate on this day. And today Jesus is saying to all of us here and all of us online to stand up, do not be afraid. I love each and every one of you. I love you with an everlasting love. I've called you by name, you are mine. And even though you might feel like Elijah, we know that we are surrounded by many angels, many messengers of God. We're here in our daily life at this moment. We'll be here with us tomorrow and every day. So from the lines of the second reading, which says, thoughts as these should comfort one another. Many resources for families who suffer grief, especially grief by suicide. So mindful today of the great work of Pieter House, all the work that families do for families, they reach out to them. This is a resource book that's provided for families in their grief. And it is just another thing that says when you lose a loved one to suicide. You may feel overwhelmed by feelings of devastation and despair. You may think you're going crazy, you won't survive. But all these feelings are normal. You are in mourning and in shock. You may feel anger at the person, at the world, at friends, at God, at yourself. And all of this too is normal. It often helps if you can find a good listener whom you can talk to about what happened and how you feel. Be open and honest about your feelings. You may feel rejected and abandoned and find yourself asking over and over again why. Why did your loved one leave you in this way? These feelings too are normal. Share them and let them out. You may feel guilty and think you could have prevented what happened. Should have known that your loved one needed help. But remember, the choice is not yours. You cannot be responsible for someone else's actions. Don't blame yourself. Don't blame others. Don't accept blame. Blaming doesn't help. You may have suicidal feelings. These feelings also are common. Doesn't mean you will act on them. Don't be afraid to cry. Cry tears, and tears help in that healing. It may be helpful to keep a diary of your thoughts, feelings, and behavior. Writing a letter to a loved one expressing how we think and feel can be therapeutic and can help the healing process. Give yourself time to heal. You know there will be setbacks. Loss of suicide creates a deep wound from which it takes a long time to recover. And lastly, seek professional advice if your feelings of grief seem overwhelming. Know that it takes several years to begin to come to terms with your loss. While life is never the same again, you can survive and even move beyond surviving. truly right and just are doing our salvation, always and ever give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, and my eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that you might, so that in your sight we all might live forever. So in common with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. In the city of me. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all your great writing is your praise. For to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rise of the sun to the setting, pure sacrifice will be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, which will make holy gifts we brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which is poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. First up, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Lord, we stand at the mortal saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, as look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the invasion of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, may be filled with his Holy Spirit, and become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May make of us eternally offered to you that we may clean our hearts and secure elect, especially those blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, your blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, Saint Stephen, and all your saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence grew life from the feeling you had. With this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Please confirm with faith and charity your pilgrim church in earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, all the clergy and the entire people of Gain Fuel. So listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. All gathered here in this church hall, outside in the rain, all joining us online, and all who are here in spirit.
through him, and with him, and in him. O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. The sacred command and form of divine teaching, we stand, we can, and dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. When you say the word, and my soul shall be. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
That there are Sorry for coming, who is the way?
itself an equally powerful song.
Half a mile of us. Ha ha.